After Sage Accounting has been moved to a new server, there's actually an issue where estimating is remembering the old server. So there's going to be two videos on this, one from what to do on the database perspective to fixing the database so future estimates will be fixed, and then another one for how to fix individual estimates, because any estimates created before the day you set up, change your database, any of those will need to be updated. So this one's going to focus on the database aspect. So on your start bar, you should be able to go off and find your Sage Estimating Management Console. So in the Management Console is where we go to fix the database. So we need to go to Standard DB. We need to find the database that is the problem. So I'm going to pick this particular database, but you may have something different. So I went to Standard DB, shows me a list of all my databases. So if your company uses multiple ones, you might have to go down and do this to each one of them. So in my case, this is my database that I'm going to be picking. If I go up to edit at the top here and then come on down and look, it'll tell me what job cost system it's set up for. And mine has Sage 100 in here, but yours will probably have like Sage 300 in there. And we need to set it to none so it forgets about what it thinks it knows about the old server. So I'm going to change that to none. I'm just going to hit save. I'm going to stay in the same screen. I'm going to go right back to edit. And then I'm going to go back and change this back to 300. And then when I get to setup, this little box will pop up that I can go now and tell it where is my data at. So that way it'll give me a new opportunity to select where my new server is for accounting. So when I hit select here, it'll probably have us log into accounting. So your username and password for the accounting. It'll bring up a list of your companies. So you'll pick whatever company it is, ties together with. And then you can go down and map out, you know, what categories are going to what. Labor, materials, sub in my case, equipment, and other. I usually do not hit this box because that way all whatever you have set up in your database will stay. So I don't want it to repush this on the items in case someone's, you know, modified the database to something different. So I'll just hit OK. I do usually like to do crew hours as man hours when they transfer to accounting and save. So that's what it takes to fix the database. So any future estimates from this point forward, once that's changed, will be to the right accounting system. So please check out the other video on how to fix an estimate.